Hello everyone, today we'll discuss the part 48 of the important notes for biochemistry so that you can easily able to answer the one liner and the MCQs in your exam. So first we'll discuss about the techniques in the molecular biology. Now which samples are taken for the prenatal diagnosis? So they are basically three. That is, first of all, amniotic fluid known as the amniocentesis gestation, CVS or the chorionic villus sampling, then after the 11 weeks of the gestation, and the third is the fetal blood sampling, then after 18 weeks of the gestation. So over here, this is the figure of the amniocentesis, okay, and this is the figure of the chorionic villus sampling. Now adult samples which can be taken from the DNA testing are blood samples, basically WBCs, cheek swab or head. Epigenetics is information in the genome which alter the pattern of the gene expression. Okay, and this is chemical modification of the DNA or the protein, but is not changed in the DNA code. Epigenetic changes are transferred to next generation and are reversible. The epigenetic changes are basically caused due to the DNA methylation, post-translational modifications of the histones. And this basically occurs mostly on the lysine residue on the proteins, and also changes in the high order of the chromosome structure causes the epigenetic changes. DNA methylation of the cytosine of the CG sites is done by the enzyme DNA methyltransferases. Acetylation of the histone is basically done by the enzyme histone acetyltransferase. Deacetylation of the histone is done by the enzyme histone deacetylase. Histone methylation can be done by the histone methyltransferases. Epigenetic changes causes disease such as cancer, aging, and even Fragile X syndrome. The Fragile X syndrome is the expansion of the CGG triplet repeat in the FMR1 gene. Okay, we discussed about this in our previous videos also. Okay. And therefore, the gene silencing basically is followed by the lack of the FMRP expression and Fragile X mental retardation. FMR1 gene, that means the Fragile X mental retardation gene, is present on the long arm of the X chromosome, which codes for the Fragile X mental retardation protein, which is required for the development of the connection between the neurons. Okay, but in this Fragile X syndrome, this particular gene basically gets mutated, because over here there occurs the expansion of the CGG nucleotide triplet. We discussed about this before in our previous videos also, right? Genetic anticipation. Now what is this? The number of the repeats increases from generation to generation until affected individual is produced, is known as the genetic anticipation. Epigenetic changes regulate the gene expression. It basically inactivates the X chromosome and has role in the genetic imprinting and defense mechanism. Now euchromatin is transcriptionally active. Okay, as you can see over here, this is the heterochromatin part and this is the euchromatin part, right? So over here, as you can see, the euchromatin part is transcriptionally active and is less condensed, while the heterochromatin part is transcriptionally inactive and is more condensed. Okay. Facultative heterochromatin means the chromatin has the ability to become transcriptionally active again. For example, X chromosome inactivation in the female mammals. Okay. Basically, we can say the bar bodies formation, right? Constitutive heterochromatin is always inactive and repetitive and usually present in the centromere and the telomere and provides the structural role. So today up till here, we will discuss about the further important notes in our further next video. Thank you so much.